Content boxes on a web page are like handy organizers. They help showcase information in a way that catches the eye. These boxes typically contain essential elements such as an icon, a heading, a brief description, and a call to action. Beyond mere functionality, the aesthetic appeal of content boxes plays a crucial role in catching the attention of visitors. In this video, we will create such a layout and spice that up with a cool hover effect. Plus, we will make sure that the boxes are keyboard-friendly for a better user experience. But before we dive into the exciting stuff, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss out on our future tutorials. All right, let's jump right in. We have got a simple HTML page set up with a title and a section ready for the content boxes. Inside the section, we have defined a separate div for each of the boxes. Our CSS file is also prepped up with some foundational styles to lay out the page. Now let's start adding child elements. First up, we're going to tap into the power of Bootstrap icons by including their CDN link in the head section of our HTML. This quick step will give us easy access to their stylish icon library. When it comes to integrating third-party utilities like this, using a public CDN is a popular choice for simplicity. However, directly adding such libraries into the codebase might be a better solution in some cases, especially for a large-scale project. Next up, let's add a div specifically for the icon and give it a CSS class called ContentBoxIcon. Thanks to Bootstrap, we can take advantage of their predefined classes for the icons we want to use. Now, let's add the box title, a brief description, and a link for the call to action. If you notice, we are sticking to a CSS naming convention, where we use a descriptive label after a block identifier. In this case, content box serves as the identifier, while title, desk, and CTA represent the child elements. Of course, if you have your preferred naming convention, feel free to stick with that. Let's replicate this setup for another box. This is what our barebone page looks like. Moving on to the style sheet, first, we need the CSS for the section. We use the Content Boxes class and transform it into a CSS grid with a single column layout and a gap of one rem between columns. Then, we set up a media query to handle the layout adjustment. When the browser's viewport width reaches 768 pixels or more, our grid will switch to a two-column layout for improved aesthetics. This will ensure that boxes are nicely spaced out and organized for bigger screens. See how it changes the layout from a single column to two columns depending on the viewport width. Following that, each box will have a subtle padding to ensure the content within doesn't stick to its edges. A delicate box shadow is applied to create a depth between the boxes and the page background. Moving on, the icon within each box will have simple styling, with font sizing and a bottom margin set to maintain a harmonious appearance. Similar to the icon, the title class also applies minimal presentational styles. To elevate the design, let's introduce a divider between the heading and the description. We can achieve this by utilizing the after pseudo element, positioned absolutely with a width of 30% and a height of 1 pixel to mimic the separator. Alternatively, we could also opt for the border property instead of the background color to achieve a similar effect. Since we are using absolute positioning with the pseudo element, it's crucial to set the title class as position relative to ensure proper alignment. Then comes the call to action. The link within the CTA block is styled with some straightforward CSS rules, primarily for font size, weight, border, and padding to achieve a button-like appearance. In this setup, the color property is using the current color keyword as its value. This keyword acts like a variable, inheriting the current value of the color property from its parent block. This means that if we define a color, let's say red, for the CTA block, the same color will cascade down to its child elements, ensuring consistency throughout and simplifying future updates to color properties. Furthermore, the margin block property will add top and bottom margins to the CTA, providing a breathing space around the button and enhancing its visibility. Now, let's return to the HTML and add an overlay for today's effect. Following the same naming convention, we will assign the CSS class Content Box Overlay to this div. Additionally, setting the ARIA hidden attribute to true will remove it from the accessibility tree, allowing screen readers to skip over it. Heading back to our CSS, the overlay class will be positioned absolutely. The inset property is the shorthand and the logical counterpart for the top, bottom, left, and right properties. Now, let's add a background image sourced from unsplash.com. Currently, the image extends beyond the intended boundaries, likely due to the absolute positioning of the overlay without proper containment by its parent element. We can fix it by adding the position relative to the content box CSS class. Setting background size to cover will align the image appropriately within its box. While the alignment of the image is fixed, it now covers other elements. The z-index property, in this case, can be used to resolve this issue. To enhance readability, we can add another layer of the background atop the image. If you don't know, it's possible to include multiple layers of background within a single CSS rule. This CSS adds a linear gradient background on top of the image. One of the colors used in the gradient has opacity, ensuring the image remains visible while providing a backdrop. To ensure that the overlay is only visible upon hovering over the box and remains hidden in its normal state, we can leverage the transform property. With the value of -100% on the y-axis, we can effectively move the overlay out of the visible boundaries. Additionally, to ensure that any content outside the box remains hidden, we will include the overflow hidden property in the content box. This will neatly conceal any overflowing content. Next up, we use the hover pseudo class to bring the overlay back into the play by resetting its position on the y-axis. To ensure a polished transition, we can employ the transition property. This will animate the changes while providing a seamless and visually pleasing effect. There is one small issue with our current setup. This effect only triggers when we hover over the boxes with a mouse, but it doesn't work if we navigate using the keyboard. This can be fixed by adding the focus within pseudo-class to the same CSS rule. This simple addition ensures that the effect is triggered not only when hovering, but also when any descendant element of the content box gains focus. This way, keyboard users can also enjoy the interactive experience. If you're interested in learning more about enhanced accessibility using focus pseudo-classes, be sure to check out our dedicated video on the topic. Then the content should also be optimized for the hover state. A simple solution is to change the text color to white for the content blocks. We can further simplify this CSS using the is pseudo-class selector. Instead of adding a new line for each of the blocks, we can include all of them within the is function. This update will greatly enhance the efficiency and readability of the code. It is also possible to combine parent selectors using another is function, enabling us to group the hover and focus within pseudo-classes. We have another video describing is and where pseudo-class selectors and how we can leverage them to improve our workflow. Check that out for further explanation. Then, adding a transition for the color property will ensure a seamless interchange when the box is hovered over or focused. Lastly, let's address the default outline that appears when using the keyboard to navigate. While these outlines serve to assist users and enhance accessibility, they might not align with our design specifications. We can style them to better match the design using the outline CSS property. By incorporating such hover effects, web designers can enhance the aesthetics of a website while boosting user engagement. Whether it's a subtle fade-in of additional information or a striking color change, hover effects inject depth and personality into content boxes, making them stand out on a web page. Feel free to explore the code provided at the link in the description. If you found this video informative, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you the next time.